I'm giving a presentation on the Mangalacharana Sandhi of Harikatha Mukhasara. Before I start the presentation, I'll begin by reciting the beginning of Harikatha Mukhasara. Harikatamrtasara guru gada karuna nindapani tu kelue parama bhagavad dattari ganadaradi keludu. So first let's talk about what the Mangalacharana Sandhi is. It's the first sandhi in the Grantha of Harikathamrtasara written by Sri Jagannath Dasaru. Harikathamrtasara has a total of 33 sandhis including Parastuti. Mangalacharana Sandhi is done as a prayer for taking away all the obstacles in our path. Mangala means auspicious and Charana means performing. So Mangalacharana means auspicious prayers filled with devotion performed for removing difficulties and hardships. Even devotees of God who are above obstacles still do Mangalacharana in order to set an example and show the path for others. So Jagannath Dasaru turned Mangalacharana into a sandhi in Harikathamrtasara to guide us in the right path. Sandhi means collection. So Mangalacharana Sandhi is a collection of auspicious prayers performed to remove obstacles. So now let's discuss what is in Mangalacharana Sandhi. Mangalacharana Sandhi has 13 padyas, but this number of padyas was not decided randomly. Jagannath Dasaru decided this number 13 based on the fact that this sandhi is like offering deepa to the Lord. Deepa is a symbol of knowledge because it gives light. In the Kannada alphabet, Dha is the third akshara in Dhavarga. So it's number 3. And Pa is the first akshara in Pa Varga, so Pa. That gives us 3-1. Dha gives us 3-1. But we read the numbers in reverse order. So that gives us 1-3. So that's why it's 13 padyas. The topic of each verse in Mangalacharana Sandhi is based off the order of the Kaksha Taratamya. Kaksha Taratamya is the ranking of devas based on their knowledge and devotion to God. It starts from first Vishnu, then Lakshmi, then Brahma Vayu, then Saraswati Bharati, etc. So for each Padya and Mangalacharana Sandhi, Dasaru prays to each of these devas. The first one is Lord Narasimha, then Lakshmi, then Brahma, then Vayu, then Saraswati, then Bharati, and then he prays to gurus, Vedavyasa, Madhvacharya, Rudra, and then in the final podcast, he prays to devotees of God, and then he prays to Jagannath Vittala with Sankita in the last padya. The first six padyas go in order of the Kaksha Taratamya based on the devas. So the first podcast, he prays to Narasimha, then Lakshmi, then Brahma, and then in the seventh and eighth and ninth padyas, he prays to the Guru Rupas that came on earth. So he prays to Veda Vyasa and Madhvacharya, still based on Kaksha Taratamya, but in the Rupas that came on earth. Then after that, he gives Rudra a verse because Rudra was taught by Madhvacharya. Then Padhyas are dedicated. Then the Padhyas are dedicated to devotees of the Guru. So in Mangalacharana Sandhi, Dasaru taught us how to do Namaskara according to Taratamya, which is very important. Thank you to Keshava Baba because he gave me all the information for this presentation, and thanks Rama for helping me with it. That's it.